All right, this is the Central Machinery 16-speed floor drill press, item number 38144 from Harbor Freight. We've been looking at these. They went on sale, had some coupons, so it was a steal of a deal. All right, here's the inside of the box. There's the instruction manual and the drill plate or bed, whatever you'd want to call it. Instruction manual, don't need that. And there's everything in there. The box was a little beat up on the outside, but the inside, along with the styrofoam and everything, was good. Just the outside of the box was beat up. So we'll get everything out and see how quick it takes to put it together. Looks fairly simple. May not even need the instructions for it. All right, here it is completely assembled. It's over 5 feet tall. This base, or this plate, swivels 360. It has a locking pin. This moves as well. All this, here's the motor. And there's the speeds that you get. Again, this is item number 38144. 220 to 3600 RPM. Chuck capacity 7/64 to 5/8. Spindle stroke is 3 1/8 of an inch, and the table tilt is 0 to 45 degrees. So here's the inside. Now it does show you how to put the belts and everything. One thing you want to check, and one thing we notice, is the height of this motor, and some other videos talk about it. You really want to run a straight edge across the top of those pulleys and have them all in line and make your adjustments, because you will wear out belts. There'll be a lot of vibrations and everything. But other than that, it seems like a decent unit. Here's the adjuster. You would loosen this wing nut and the other wing nut over here, and you just loosen it. That is the spring tensioner. You can adjust it, but it came perfect from Harbor Freight, so it wasn't bad. And just your throw. You have your graduations down there, and you can move it up and down with the handle. Moves nice. And we have a pull-out lockout tab here where you can just pull it out and you can't turn it on. Pretty quiet. Again, check the belt deflection. Check everything in there. Make sure it's all straight before you actually want to run something, but it is very smooth. Extremely smooth. All right, we're going to test the runout now, and hopefully this thing is smooth and has a good runout of less than a couple thousandths, because the box was banged up. If it's not, it's going back. All right, we got the dial indicator set up on the arbor with the chuck attached. We want to kind of check the runout with everything hooked up. We do have the points on it closed. And we'll show you how sensitive this dial indicator is. We're tapping the plastic up here, and you'll see it's very sensitive. So it'll pick up the slightest movements, and see it centered back. It is right on that arbor in there. So we're gonna turn it on and we're gonna see how much runout we have. As you can see, it's turning on there. You see it's leaving a witness mark. This is the lowest speed, like 950 RPM. And look at that. Amazing. Straight out of the box. The box was banged up. So this is definitely a really good deal. And right there, back on zero. See, it's contacting it. We'll do it again just to show you. That's less than, what, 20 thousandths there? Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments, but, or maybe it's 100 thousandths. No, it's 20 thousandths, because each graduation is 10 thousandths. Not too bad at all. It is pretty straight out the box, so we think that this will definitely serve our needs. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.